Jeepers, it's perfect!
No, I didn't mean for you to see this.
Look, I know it isn't Christmas Day yet, but I can act surprised on the day, I promise. Pez? What's wrong? I'm sorry, I didn't mean to spoil the surprise.
It's not that. I was trying to put it online. To sell it.
Why would you do that? Have I done something wrong?
No. No, it's got nothing to do with you. Ste and my mum are so skint they can't even afford to buy the kids Christmas presents. I felt dead guilty I'd spent so much on this when I know they're struggling.
I had no idea Ste was in such dire straits.
We all are. And now they've lost that cleaning contract. Be lucky if we can even afford Christmas dinner.
Oh, you poor little creatures. Can't bear the thought of you all huddled together, penniless. It's like something out of Dickens.
Look, Ste should have told me. We're supposed to be a partnership.
He's selling stuff to try and make money, so I thought I should do the same. I'm sorry, Jules. I know I've let you down.
You haven't. Don't be daft. Look, I don't need a locket to know how much you love me.
Especially one as tacky as that.
Darling, it's a thought that counts.
Oh, is it? Oh, sorry. Well, as gaudy as that locket is, it is staying where it is. I'm going to speak to Ste. Sort this out once for all.
We did our Christmas list in school. Max Finley's list is huge. It covers 3 pages, but I changed mine. Look.
What happened to all the computer games you were after? The scooter.
I don't need loads of presents. Make up for it next year when you're not skint. Don't feel bad, Dad.
Now that is the true spirit of Christmas. Yeah? Family, caring, and sharing. Sharing when one of you is struggling and not having to hear it from Peri.
I don't know what she told you, but
she was about to sell a tacky locket she gave Juliet just to put food on the table. Why don't you tell me things have got so tough?
Because it's not your problem. When I was a kid, every Christmas, my stepdad left us penniless and I swore I would never put these two through that and I would never need charity.
Well, that's preposterous. You know, I would never give to charity. All right, the last time I passed a collection box, I dropped a button in it just for sport. Like, seriously, this is what partners are for. If by some bizarre twist of fate I found myself struggling financially, you'd move heaven and earth to help me, right?
Right.
Right. So drop the pride. And let me take the reins, pun intended.
Don't want my kids thinking that you can provide for them and I can't.
I'll keep everything low-key. I'll just help out with the cash flow. I promise I won't go over the top.
Okay. But I'm going to pay you back.
Is the correct answer. In whichever bizarre fashion I see fit. Now, let's go and pick up Leah from dance, have a sickeningly festive meal, and if you're very lucky, I may even don a Santa hat.
Come on.